Dear friends, today we will discuss Archimedean property of R. And Archimedean property of R is a good application of supremum property of real numbers. Okay, so first we state the Archimedean property of R. So if X and Y are two real numbers such that one of them is positive, okay, then there exists a natural number such that n x is bigger than, strictly bigger than y. Okay, proof. Okay, here given that x is a positive real number and y is any real number. Okay, now by law of trichotomy we know that either y is less or equal to 0 or y is positive. Okay, so if y is less or equal to 0, then obviously x is strictly bigger than y. So here n is nothing but 1. Okay, now let us assume that y is positive. Okay, then what will happen? Claim, if y is positive, then our claim is that there exists a natural number n belongs to script n such that the product of n with x is strictly bigger than y. So this is our claim. So if the claim is not true, then what will happen? So if the claim is false, then what will happen? Then in x is less or equal to y for all in. Now we construct a set S that is collection of all in x or in belongs to script n. Okay, now we construct this set. Then the first observation is that x belongs to the set S. Okay, this implies S is non-empty. Okay, second observation is that S is bounded above. Okay, since S is non-empty and bounded above, So by supremum property of R, this set has an supremum. S has the supremum. Say the supremum is B. Okay, now we apply the property of supremum. So B is the supremum. Now for any epsilon positive, there exists an element Px belongs to S such that B minus epsilon is strictly less than Px, where P is a natural number. Since this inequality is true for every epsilon positive, so we choose epsilon equal to X. Okay, then for that epsilon, there exists an element P dash X belongs to S such that B minus X is strictly less than P dash X, where P dash is nothing but a natural number, and this implies is B is strictly less than P dash plus 1 multiplied by X. So, we have seen that this element is an element from S, okay. So, in S, there is an element P dash plus 1 into X which is bigger than the supremum of the set S. That is not possible. That is a contradiction, okay. That is, if X and Y both are positive, then obviously there exists a natural number N such that Nx is strictly bigger than Y, okay. Okay, so now we discuss some applications of Archimedean property. The first application. If epsilon positive is a positive real number, then there exists a natural number N such that 0 strictly less than 1 by N strictly less than epsilon. So, proof of this result. Okay. Here, x equal to epsilon and y equal to 1. So, if we apply Archimedean property, then there exists a natural number n belongs to n such that nx is strictly greater than y, that is n into epsilon is strictly greater than 1, that is 1 by n is strictly less than epsilon, and that is 0 strictly less than 1 by n strictly less than epsilon. Okay, this completes the proof. So, next exercise. If t is equal to 1 by n, where n belongs to script n, then show that infimum of the set t is nothing but 0. Okay. And this follows from this conclusion 1 and the definition of infimum. Okay. Okay. Next exercise. If epsilon is any positive quantity, then there exists a natural number such that 0 strictly less than 1 by 2 to the power n strictly less than epsilon. Okay. So, this exercise is easy if we keep our mind that 2 to the power n is strictly bigger than n. Next application of Archimedean property. If x is any real number, then there exists a natural number n such that n is bigger than x. And the proof is obvious, because we know that 1 is positive and x is any real number, okay. So, by Archimedean property, there exists a natural number n such that 1 into n is strictly bigger than x, that is n is strictly bigger than x, and this completes the proof. Okay. Okay. So, next exercise. Okay. Show that supremum of natural numbers is nothing but infinity. So, this exercise follows from conclusion 2. Okay. So, natural number is unbounded. Okay. Thus, Archimedean property implies is the set of natural number is unbounded. Okay. If we assume that the set of natural number is unbounded, then Archimedean property is true. What is true? So let us take two real numbers, x and y. Okay. So actually, if x is positive and y is negative, then there is nothing to prove. So without loss of generality, here we assume that x is positive and y is positive. Okay. So if Archimedean property is false, then in x less or equal to y for all natural numbers. Since x is strictly positive, so n is less or equal to y by x for all n belongs to script n. Okay. So this implies is set of natural is bounded. Okay. But our assumption was set of natural is unbounded. So the fact n x less or equal to y for all n belongs to n is false. That means there exists at least one natural number n such that n x is strictly bigger than y, and that is nothing but Archimedean property. Okay. So we have seen that Archimedean property implies set of naturals is unbounded, and here we establish that if the set of naturals is unbounded, then the Archimedean property is true. So we conclude that Archimedean property is equivalent to set of naturals is unbounded. So set of naturals is unbounded. This is another formulation of Archimedean property. Okay. So next result. If y is any real number, any positive real number, then there exists a natural number m such that y lies between the two consecutive integers m minus 1 and m. Okay. So we prove this result. Proof. Let us construct a set E as all those natural numbers which are strictly bigger than y. Okay. Then the first observation is that this set is non-empty because of Archimedean property. Since natural numbers is unbounded and y is a positive real numbers, so obviously by Archimedean property there exists a natural number which is bigger than y. So by Archimedean property this set is non-empty set. Okay. And obviously this is the subset of natural numbers. Okay. So E is a non-empty subset of natural numbers. So by well ordering property of natural numbers. So by well ordering property of natural numbers, the set E has a least element. The set E has a least element. Say the least element is m. Okay. So obviously m minus 1 does not belongs to E. Okay. So this implies is since m minus 1 does not belongs to E, so m minus 1 is less or equal to y. Okay. And since m is a element of the set E, so m is obviously bigger than y. Okay. And this completes the proof. That is, every positive real number lies between two consecutive integers. Okay. So next application of Archimedean property. This is a very important property, and this property is known as density property. density property of reals. That is, if x and y are two real numbers such that x is strictly less than y, then there exists a rational number r in between x and y. So the result is, between every two real numbers there are at least one rational numbers. Okay, so proof of this result: given that x is strictly less than y, that is y minus x is positive, so by Archimedean property there exists a natural number n such that n into y minus x is strictly bigger than y. Okay, that is n y is strictly bigger than n x plus 1. So n y is strictly bigger than n x plus 1, and that is strictly bigger than n x. Okay, since x is a real number, so by law of trichotomy, either x is strictly positive or x is less or equal to 0. Now we assume here that x is positive. Okay, if x is positive, then index is positive, so we can apply this result. So by this result, there exists a natural number m such that m minus 1 is less or equal to nx, less or equal to strictly less than m. Okay, so thus, combining these two result, we have n y is strictly greater than n x plus 1, and n x plus 1 is strictly greater than m. Okay, and m is strictly greater than n x. So this implies is y strictly greater than m by n, strictly greater than x. Okay, thus if x is positive, then we establish that there exists a rational number in between y and x. Okay, now we consider the case when x less or equal to 0. Okay, so if x is 0, then there is nothing to prove. Okay, and if x is negative, then we consider two cases: x is negative and y is positive, and x is negative and y is negative, and those are the simple manipulation, so we leave it for the audience. Okay, so next result, that is again an application of Archimedean property, which tells that between any two real numbers there exist at least one irrational numbers. Okay, so if x and y are two real numbers such that x is strictly less than y, then there exists an irrational number z such that z lies between x and y. Okay, proof: already we know that root 2 is a irrational number. Okay, and given x is strictly less than y, so this implies is x by root 2 is strictly less than y by root 2. So since x by root 2 and y by root 2 are two real numbers, so there exists a rational number in between them. So this implies is x strictly less than r root 2 strictly less than y. Now our claim is r root 2 is a irrational number. Okay, if r root 2 is a rational number, and since r is a rational number, using this fact we can show that root 2 is a rational number, but already we know that root 2 is a irrational number, so r root 2 must be a irrational number. Okay, so thus between two real numbers there exist a irrational numbers. Okay, so combining previous two results, we can say that between any two real numbers there must exist one rational number, one irrational numbers. So the meaning of dense is here that between any two real numbers there is a one rational numbers, there is a one irrational numbers. That is the meaning of dense here. Okay, and later we will show that in between any two real numbers there are infinitely many rational numbers and uncountably many irrational numbers. Okay, thank you.